Hi everyone, Ricky here from Tech Talk. Hope you're doing well. Today I want to go through the accessibility settings on the Samsung Galaxy A5 2017. Massive thank you to Vodafone for sending this out so soon. And this video is very key to myself. I always like to take a look at these settings. As I am visually impaired, I may use these settings when actually testing out these devices. So if you do have a disability and use these settings, please leave a comment down below. It's very nice to hear from you as always, and let me know which device you maybe use them on. So first of all, you need to go into your main app drawer, then to the cog icon, which is in settings. So once you're in settings, what you need to do is scroll all the way down to the bottom and then count five up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And it's called accessibility and it's a little green man. So click on accessibility, and what I love here, Samsung has split their categories. So you've got vision, hearing, dexterity and interaction, and then a few extras. So first of all, let's go through them extras and then I'll jump into the main body of where they're split up. So first of all, you have direction lock, direct access, notification reminders, so it will remind you of notifications you maybe have on your device, answering and ending calls, so you can do these with the buttons and different motions with this phone, single tap mode, and manage accessibility settings, so you can actually make your own profile what you prefer. So first of all, let's jump into dexterity and interaction. So first of all, the top one is universal switch, an assistive menu, tap and hold delay, so if you have any issues with the touchscreen there, and then interaction control to finish this section off. Going back, let's go into hearing. So first one is flash notification, so the LED on the back of the phone will actually flash and tell you that you may have notifications or even an incoming call and text messages. Turn off all sounds, so if you are someone that doesn't hear anything or are deaf, you turn this off and then your phone won't make any sounds, but you'll get subtitles. Moving on, you've got Samsung subtitles or Google subtitles to choose from. You can change the sound balance to left or right, it depends on yourself. Then finally, you've got mono audio as well. So moving on to vision, and this is the biggest category here, and this is one of the most important ones to myself. You have voice assistant. When this is actually toggled on, you then get these extra features. So you've got voice assistant help. You've got dark screen, where it makes your screen dark if you don't use the screen. You've got rapid key input and speak passwords. So if we go to voice assistant, if I just toggle this on, highlight this box.
While voice assistant is enabled, your device will provide voice feedback. For example, voice assistant will tell you what you can interact with on each screen. Tap items to select them and hear what they are, and double tap items to perform the related action.
So voice assistant will speak back everything that you highlight. So I can highlight the taskbar up here at the top.
Phone signal full. Battery 37%. 2341.
Okay, and it will give us our time as well. So double tap.
Switch. On switch. Alert tapping OK will stop for OK button.
So you have to highlight once and then double tap quite quickly to actually make that action come true. Like I said, when this is toggled on, these actions will be available to use as well. So moving on, you've got text to speech output, accessibility shortcut, which is a great setting. You can actually put this on your home screen. So if you don't want to come through all these menus all the time, you can actually have a shortcut on the home screen. We have voice labels. We have font size. So at the moment it's set to huge, which is nice and big for myself. We've got high contrast fonts, high contrast keyboard. You've got show button shapes, magnification window. So if I highlight this here and hit okay, you have a window here, scrolling up and down, or you can even move the window by this little tab here. You can move the window to wherever you want to have it. That's toggled on and off there. Magnification gestures, which is here. 1, 2, 3. Three quick taps and it will actually enlarge the whole device with two fingers, pinch to zoom. Then you can see how big, but how clear that still looks on this great phone. 1, 2, 3 again. You can leave that toggled on if you so wish. You have grayscale, so make the screen gray. So if you watch this blue here, it turns to gray. You have negative colors. Some people find it easier to read this way around. And then you have color adjust as well there at the bottom. That is a phenomenal amount of settings here, and I'm so pleased to see that Samsung still offer so many settings for people with disabilities so they can use these great devices. So thanks always for watching. I hope this helped. If you need any information or want to leave a comment down below, please do. Always reply to them. It's always great to hear from you. Thanks always for watching. Remember to give a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, subscribe for all our latest videos. From me, Ricky, I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.